students a yes, please be seated. One of my favorite things to say as a principal, you get to feel the power of the position, I guess. Welcome to the local scholarship evening here to celebrate the class of 2021. Yeah, go ahead. It's truly an honor and a blessing to be part of the Olmsted Falls community. And tonight, really, everything we're about is symbolized by that spirit of the Olmsted Falls community. A few weeks before we started planning our senior scholarship night, counselors kind of came to me and they were starting to panic about how we're going to pull this off in our auditorium amongst COVID. What they didn't know is that Jen Kruger, who's sitting here behind me, and Linda Barkowski emailed me a few weeks before that and said, hey, Grace Church has the largest public auditorium outside of Public Square. If the school needs anything, we'd be willing to connect you so that we could honor our kids to the best of your abilities. And so one email led into Grace Church being gracious hosts to allow our graduates and two parents attend this evening, which we wouldn't be able to pull off. So I want to thank Pastor Neil. I want to thank Pastor Jordan. And you guys and Jordan are being conduits into the pipeline to get us here this evening. I'd be remiss if I didn't thank our counselors. They do all the work behind the scenes to pull this type of evening off. All the verifications, all the contacts of the sponsors, all the work with the students, decorating the stage. It's a tireless job, and it's essentially planning, I don't know, a wedding, maybe not at that scale. But this night's not possible without Mary, Lisa, Alex, Carlos, and Amy. And so I want to give them a round of applause for all their hard work. We do have two board members in attendance this evening, Mrs. Linda Barkowski and Dr. Jody DeMarco. Thank you for attending this evening. Dr. Lloyd called me probably about 20 minutes before I arrived, and he said, make sure you let him know I could not be there because of school business. He's down in Columbus with our treasurer tonight, and then they got school business with the Ohio Department of Education on the financial side. But he made it very clear that this is one of his favorite evenings, and he wanted to make sure the class of 2021 that are being honored this evening, that he wanted to congratulate you. So he's here in spirit, and he loves Olmsted Falls, and he loves you guys. So he just wanted to say congratulations to each and every one of you. You know, speaking of community, you know, not only is this building representing that, but as I look through the program and talking to the counselors, we have a lot of past Olmsted Falls alumni paying it forward to you guys. And that means so much about what they believe in the spirit of Olmsted Falls and how much they care about the Olmsted Falls students and community. They donated over $132,000 to honor you guys and to support you guys in your next endeavor. So I personally, as the principal, want to say thank you for your efforts in recognizing and supporting these students and paying it forward. So let's give the donors a applause. If you were at Honors Banquet a couple weeks ago, I talked about not only being scholars, but really the language of kindness. Their actions are a good example of the language of kindness. So my charge, and I always talk to the students, my charge to each and every one of you is as you are a beneficiary of a scholarship tonight, that when you get the opportunities at whatever station of life, or wherever that comes in your station of life, pay it forward. Remember the future generations of Olmsted Falls and follow their example and bless those that will be graduating maybe in 2035 or whatever that case may be. But it is our hope that their act of kindness will be instilled or plant a seed of an act of kindness in your heart so that you can continue it forward. Class of 2021, this really kicks off the celebratory season. We have this, We have prom, we have the blue and gold assembly, and then ultimately we have commencement. And so I'm gonna make a news flash alert for commencement, June 3rd. Initially my publication went out and said, hey, we're gonna give each of you 6 tickets. I'm gonna save myself probably another 400 emails. What I did is I ordered some extra chairs to increase the capacity of our stadium. So when you check out on June 2nd, you're each gonna get 10 tickets for your family and your family. And lastly, as we move forward in the closure of the school year, my hope is that you start to get into the reflection mode, and you reflect on the teachers, you reflect on the peers, you reflect on your administration, and you reflect on everyone that helped you get along the way. And I hope that it's a positive reflection. And I hope you embrace that moment as you begin to start thinking about this chapter closing and moving into the next endeavors in your lives, that you look back at this time fondly. Today was an amazing day with our Special Olympics. I met some of our former students that participated in Special Olympics, and then I was talking to one young lady, and she never met me before, but the one thing that she said that was so profound, I still miss this place. It is my hope for each and every one of you that when you leave Olmsted Falls and you look back down the road, that you say something along the lines, man, I still miss this place. So God bless the class of 2021, and at this time I'm going to turn it over to Keely Patton.
Hello, I'm here to say the pledge, so please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
I do have some logistical talking points to get through before this Gale drone starts to kick off why we're really here. We have 2 podiums this evening, so really sponsors, I'm talking to you. So students, you can see how well the adults follow directions. But essentially, we are gonna ping pong the podium. So Ms. Calderon will be the first one kicking it off. I believe the next presenter is Mrs. Kristen Bravenick. So as Ms. Calderon is speaking, Ms. Bravenick will work her way to this podium. When Ms. Bravenick is done, she will introduce our next presenter. But our hope is our next presenter is already at that podium. So as this person is talking here, the next person in the program will make their way to the podium. I think I made that pretty clean, right? Secondly, students, as you come up to receive your envelope, you're gonna come up the stairs, the ones here with the railings, not the ones here that we blocked with flowers. We did that intentionally. We're gonna ask you to come up the stairs next to your podium, receive your envelope, and then you're gonna go down the stairs to the same ones you went up. So essentially, we're gonna seesaw back and forth. We're gonna ask all the adults to pay attention very closely, and then when you're next on deck, come on up and then wait patiently until you're introduced. Ms. Calderon, you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, take the seat.
All right, good evening, everyone. My name is Amy Calderon. I'm the college and career counselor for the high school, and I'd like to welcome you all to Senior Honor Night. Tonight, we're celebrating the class of 2021 and the generosity of our community through the local scholarship program. Like Mr. Spagnola, this really is one of my favorite nights. I love celebrating our students. I love our community. And I love giving out scholarships just like Oprah. I feel very much like her. So our local scholarship sponsors come from businesses and our proud alumni, our community organizations, our Olmsted Falls families, our school community. And I also would like to take a moment just to thank each and every one of you for your generosity and unwavering support for our students. In your program tonight, there is a description of each scholarship, and I would encourage you to take a look at the description. It tells you the history and the meaning behind these scholarships. They mean a lot to the people that are giving them to you. So Tonight we're going to be awarding 238 scholarships totaling $132,845. So let's take a look at that. I'd also like to extend a thank you to Mrs. Smith, our guidance administrative assistant. She really is the heart and soul of the local scholarship program. Each year, thousands of dollars worth of scholarships are awarded to our deserving seniors, but it's a result of not just our sponsors, but the dedication and hard work Mrs. Smith also puts in behind the scenes. So I'd like to also give her a round of applause. Okay, so seniors, it's been such an honor and privilege to work with you all this year on your applications and your decision making. You all worked so hard, and we are all so proud of the young adults you've become and the pathways that you've chosen after graduation. And these caps and gowns are a really good look for you guys, for real. Before we present our local scholarships, we'd like to recognize a couple students. When I call your name, please come to the stage and you can stand in the center. Noah Barrett, Jacob Aldrich, Henry Long, William Diston, and Daisy Watts. Recognize our Phi Beta Kappa recipient for the class of 2021, Noah Barrett. You can step forward. Noah was chosen by the staff as a student who demonstrates the highest standards of academic achievement and scholarship. The role of the Phi Beta Kappa is to deliver a speech at commencement. We also had four students recognized by National Merit for their outstanding achievement on the PSAT NMSQT. This year, and you guys can step forward, Jacob Aldrich, Noah Barrett, and Henry Long were among our National Merit commended students, and William Diston is our National Merit finalist. Daisy provided verification of earning a full academic scholarship to Harding University in Arkansas, where she's been named a Harding Trustee Scholar. Let's have a round of applause. When we announce your name, we're going to put your scholarship right on the table and you can pick it up from there. The Vitamix Community Scholarship goes to Tate Blaine. And next up is Kristen Bravenick.
All right, good evening, class of 2021. My name is Kristen Bravenick, and I am the district coordinator for Helping Hands. I'm truly honored to present our Helping Hands Leadership Scholarship. Helping Hands is a disability awareness program that helps people of all ages learn attitudes of acceptance, dignity, and respect toward all people, especially those with a disability. The group is designed to help students of all abilities find their place in the community, but especially within the student body. This is exactly what our students in Helping Hands have been doing. Although this past year we've missed some of our larger gatherings, we were still able to volunteer in classrooms across the district, hang out virtually, and like Mr. Spagnuolo said, host our first Bulldog Special Olympics. Although we have many amazing seniors, I would like to recognize one in particular. The student has volunteered in the moderate to intensive special education classroom for her 4 years at Olmsted Falls. Not only does she volunteer during her study halls, but any free time she has, she's hanging out with us. She has gone above and beyond to get to know all of our students on a personal level and truly treats them like peers. She has attended many field trips and events and was just a part of all students having fun. As well as treating them as her peers, she advocates for them on a daily basis, always making sure they are being treated well throughout the school and supporting them in all their activities. We truly appreciate everything you do. And it is my honor to present Michaela Ellis with the Helping Hand.
This evening. The Betty Jones Scholarship is awarded to one senior athlete, boy, and one senior athlete, girl, who exhibits pride, sportsmanship, ethics, and being a responsible teammate. This year we have two recipients, Andrew Parkowski and Allison Milligan.
Justin. My husband John Jakin was a proud Bulldog parent of four student athletes who is also a varsity football coach here at the school. He knew how important youth sports are, so he founded the Bulldog Youth Football Program as well as the Falls Freestyle Program. The Bulldog Youth Football Program has created the John Jakin Memorial Scholarship as part of the program he created. They wanted a way to honor John and the sacrifices he made over the years to get this program off the ground. This year, they're awarding two scholarships in John's name. To qualify for the scholarship, the candidate must have played or cheered in the Bulldog Youth Football Program, played football or cheered their senior year, and have a GPA of 3.0 or higher. I am honored to present this scholarship for the first time in my sweet husband's name. This year, the two recipients of the John Jakin Memorial Scholarship are Robert Joseph Simon and Thomas Raymond Bass. Mr. Dan Faust.
Good evening. My name is Dan Faust. I am the current but outgoing treasurer of the Athletic Boosters. Welcome students and all to the 2021 scholarship program. We would like to thank all parent volunteers that spend their time helping with our many fundraising activities. Also, I would like to thank the athletic department office and athletic coaches for their support of booster events, and lastly, to student athletes who provide their time and efforts in making some of our events successful. Through the efforts of many volunteers and our community support over the past several years, the Athletic Boosters have been able to provide many services to the school district's athletic programs. This past year was a challenge for the Boosters, that we are limited in what events we could hold and how many people could attend those events. This limited the amount of funds we could raise, and of course, that resulted in not being able to give as much back to the sports programs as we are accustomed to. We were fortunate to be able to hold a few fundraising activities, the most prominent of which are Bulldog Patriot Program and Gold Card Blitzes that occur in the fall and spring. And secondarily, we received notable revenues from the OFBA program, so basketball program, and Rikers Sports through its apparel rebates. These events allowed Boosters to fund a few programs this year, one of which is tonight's. We are hopeful next school year will allow for some return to normalcy so we can get back to the business of helping our athletes and sports programs. We appreciate the support of this community and ask that you get involved in the Athletic Boosters and that you stay involved. It truly benefits our student athletes. One final shout out to the scholarship committee who gave them their time in going through the many student applications. We thank you. So on behalf of the Olmsted Falls Athletic Boosters, congratulations to the following 12 seniors who are this year's scholarship recipients. Carson Balfour. Ryan Piskanic.
The Olmsted Falls Volleyball Association is a club in the Ohio Valley region that exists to build the skills of young Olmsted Falls City School volleyball players and feed into the Olmsted Falls middle and high school volleyball programs. In order to run our program, all coaches volunteer their time, and due to this, we are able to give scholarships to deserving graduating volleyball players. Olmsted Falls High School volleyball players run youth camps, skill clinics, and junior netters programs every summer and fall for incoming players. After long practices, these high school girls give back to the community by coaching and being mentors to the little ones looking up to them. The OFBA Scholarship Award winners must show leadership in these coaching and mentoring opportunities. I am pleased to be able to award two scholarships this year. This class is the class of girls that started the OFBA program as third graders. The two deserving seniors have given back to the Olmsted Falls volleyball community by sacrificing their time to help the youth volleyball program in Olmsted Falls grow. One of the girls was a four-year OFHS volleyball player who gave back to the youth in her off-season, helping develop young players. and another never played for OFHS volleyball and still chose to volunteer her time to be an assistant coach for our 12-year-old team for all 4 years. Their dedication allows for the OFBA club to exist and thrive. The OFBA scholarship recipients for 2021 are Allie Spellacy and Keely Catton. The next scholarship will be the Olmsted Falls Kiwanis Scholarship.
The recipient of the Charlotte Hazel Memorial Scholarship is Alexis Wendling. The recipient of the Mike Del Piso Memorial Scholarship is Anthony DeMarco. And the recipient of the Wynn Barbie Memorial Scholarship is Connor Simon.
Congratulations, class of 2021. Our first recipient is Noah Barrett. William Diston. Claire Oliver. Daisy Watts. And Nathan Wickert. Next up is Donovan Kennedy.
Congratulations, class of 2021. I'm here to present the Olmsted Chamber of Commerce Scholarship, which promotes volunteerism and business growth in Olmsted Township and Olmsted Falls. Our scholarship recognizes two students this evening who demonstrated that volunteerism and entrepreneurial spirit. Our 2021 Olmsted Chamber of Commerce Scholarship winners are Catherine Doherty and Adam Kwan. Township Trustee Lisa Fair.
Congratulations, class of 2021. My name is Lisa Zver, and I'm one of the trustees here in Olmsted Township. On behalf of the Olmsted Township Board of Trustees, we want to congratulate the following students for receiving a $650 scholarship. Catherine Garreau, Adam Kwan, and Claire Oliver.
Many students in the Olmsted Falls school system and so many families in the Olmsted community rallied around Dakota and our family to raise money towards research for here and to help make Dakota more comfortable. The three kids receiving scholarships from us today gave up their free time while at Ovis to help Dakota and her classmates. They would come before school and give up their recess time to assist the kids in the special needs classroom. They even continued to help when they moved on to middle school, coming in early to help at Opus before walking over to the middle school. I'm honored that Dakota's teacher, Gabby Jamboy Green, is here to kind of hold me up and help me present this scholarship. While all of these students are absolutely amazing, one of these kids was extra special to Dakota and our family. She is truly, in every sense of the word, Dakota's friend. She took a special interest in Dakota, even though Dakota couldn't interact with her like a traditional kid might. She looked past all of her inabilities and just showed her love and appreciated her for who she was. This love for her friend outweighed the difficulty of watching her friend's disease progress and eventually passing away in April of 2014. I never do this. I never cry when I do this talk. She even mustered the courage to speak and read a poem at Dakota's funeral, ironically in this very building, with a crowd about this size, when she was in fifth grade. So try to imagine that. To this day, she continues to visit Dakota's resting place. She is a very special friend of Dakota and will forever hold a special place in the heart of the Binn family. She's an amazing young lady with the heart and courage to match her tremendous talents. She will be receiving the largest scholarship we have ever given. My husband's hoping it's the largest that's ever been given at Olmsted Falls, but I don't know. No one deserves it more, and the Binn family will do whatever we can to help her reach her full potential. We know Dakota's watching down on her and is very proud of her and the other students receiving the scholarship today. We like to think that Dakota's legacy is carried forward by great people,
like Mia, Austin, and Bailey, and so many others in this community who took the time to get to know Dakota and support our family and our cause. Best of luck to our recipients, and I'm gonna name them in a second, but when you come up here, stand here and look out because your parents are gonna wanna take a picture of you. Mia Marsico, Austin Flint, and Bailey Scott.
This year's recipient of the Learning to Step Life Lesson Scholarship. Good evening, I'm Heather Hetzler, and I'm the founder of L2S. This is the fourth year that we've been giving a scholarship. This scholarship is based solely on teacher recommendation and essay. While we believe firmly that grades and ACT scores are important, we also believe that it is a person's emotional intelligence that truly decides their path in life, how they face struggles, because we all face them. Are they compassionate to others? Do they persevere? And do they learn when they fall down and stand? This year's recipient of the Learning to Step Life Lesson embodies all of this and more. And this year's recipient shared with their essay how they've been preparing and looking forward to their spring 2020 sport season, but COVID ended it and drastically impacted their ability to train. But this person did not give up. They were saddened. They grieved their loss. But they decided to volunteer with their family business, knowing that working physically hard would keep their body in shape and their mind mentally fit. This student refused to allow the halt in the 2020 sports season to keep them down. They grieved the loss. They didn't blame or try and disregard their mandates. They found a way to keep engaged in the new normal. They demonstrated resilience, grit, and a servant's heart by helping their family business. They made a way. In their own words, I want to share an excerpt from their essay. The unprecedented events from COVID-19 led me to find different outlets to release the stress and uncertainty that I dealt with. When curveballs were thrown my way, I had to rise to the occasion and focus on bettering myself. The world, along with my sport career, remains uncertain. But I am prepared to remain resilient and versatile while adjusting to anything that is thrown my way. I am determined not only to be a first-generation college student, but also to continue to set higher goals for myself and consistently exceed those expectations. This is a 17-year-old. Someone can grieve losses and learn to overcome the struggles. He has resilience and a healthy way of addressing struggles. This is the stuff that defines a person who will be successful in whatever they do, because they know that their circumstances don't define them, but they get to choose how they face their struggles. They know that when you fall down, and everyone does, that you get back up and you stand and you find a way. So it is my honor this year to present this year's Learning to Step Life Lesson and to meet for the first time, Austin McGray.
To award the Lenore Warning Memorial Scholarship
given in honor of and in memory of my wife, Lenora. We're going to award four scholarships. Please hold your applause till after we name on everybody. Ashley Keener, Alicia Serrano, Mallory Norton, and Alex Kandoff.
The next scholarship is the Stoker Family Scholarship. I am not Kyle Stoker. Unfortunately, he planned to be here tonight and had a work emergency and couldn't be here. I'm Kathy Hess, the Olmsted Falls Alumni Director, and I'm proud to be up here to present this scholarship. It is an inaugural scholarship. He and his wife generously decided to create a scholarship in their family name, and the recipient is someone who demonstrates excellence in athletic competition and in the classroom, someone who shows consistent work ethic and tenacity to excel in their 4 years of high school, and they were generous enough to make this a $5,000 scholarship. And that recipient is Lindsay Lapinta.
This year's award goes to a person who exemplifies excellence in Olmsted Falls, Riley Ivey. Caroline
our named and endowed scholarships. I'll start with our multi-year scholarships, and the four-year recipient of the Greg Butcher Scholarship is R.J. Simon. The two-year recipient of the Amelia Harding Memorial Endowed is Caitlin Capusta. Two-year recipient of the Captain Charles A. Harding Memorial Endowed, Henry Long. The two-year recipient of the Clara Harding Memorial Endowed is Claire Oliver. I'm Claire's mom. The remaining scholarships are one-year awards. The James A. McFadden Memorial Scholarship for Excellence and Friendship goes to Rebecca Abbott. The Aurora and Norman Spiro Memorial recipient is Amanda Wu. George C. Schneider Memorial Endowed goes to Rachel Corva. The Gordon Boddy Memorial Endowed recipient is Cody Weichel. The John Sanders Memorial Endowed goes to Tyler Lofton. The Leonard A. and Betty J. Davidson Memorial Endowed recipient is Mallory Norton. Mrs. Caldron was right. I do feel a little bit like Oprah. The following four students are recipients of the Robert A. Venefra Endowed Scholarship. Anthony DeMarco. Lauren Velasco. George Kerr. And Sharice McGee. Rebecca Johnson and Holly Keller. The recipients of the Charles A. Harding Scouts and Military Scholarship are Christian Crossy and Theo Humphrey. The recipients of the Clara Harding Business Scholarship. Mia Marsico. The class of 1959 recipient is Maggie Lloyd. The Craig R. Sedley Memorial Endowed Scholarship goes to Jimmy Lippis. The two recipients of the Dallas Family Memorial Endowed are Kevin Allen and Allie Selassie. The Decker Family Endowed Scholarship recipient is Tom Bass. The Dr. Frank L. Rigoni Endowed Scholarship recipient is Manny Yodigay. The Jacob T. Caskey Leadership and Community Service Scholarship goes to Alexis Wendman. The Joanne Manefra Kasich 1956 Memorial Scholarship recipient is Jerry White. The retired staff endowed recipient is Connor Simon. Next, I would like to introduce alumni board member John Story. Class of 1997 will be presenting our newest alumni scholarship.
Thank you, Christina. I'm John Story, Secretary of the Alumni Association. It's good to be home. I'm here to present the inaugural Harding Hicks Seiler Public Service Scholarship. This award would not exist without the Harding Family Charitable Trust, and for their name multiple times already tonight, PNC trustees and the Cleveland corporate community, who generously granted our association $100,000 to endow this award for as many as 5 1,000 scholarships each year moving forward. Before we give away the money, I think you should know a little bit more about Charles Harding and Michael Hicks Seiler. I'll start with Charles Harding and the Harding family legacy within our organization in this city. To whom much is given, much will be required. The Hardings live by this verse and have used their philanthropy to help others on the southwest side of Cleveland. From supporting Southwest Hospital in Baldwin Wallace, to their support of the high school's Performing Arts Center Improvements Project in recent times, we are fortunate as an association, we preferred beneficiaries of this family and their trust. We thank you. Charles Harding graduated from Olmsted Falls High class of 1933. He was drafted in the United States Army in 1941, rose from infantry private to a captain, 612th Tank Destroyer Battalion. He died during the invasion at Normandy Beach in the summer of 44. He was 29 years old. His legacy and name lives on in this town thanks to his sisters, Amelia and Clara. The Olmsted Falls High School football stadium has long been the Harding Charles A. Harding Memorial Stadium, and the most photographed structure in our fair city is the Charles A. Harding Memorial Covered Bridge. Tonight, Mr. Harding's legacy marches onward in the joint naming of his scholarship with a fellow Army mate. Let me tell you about my friend Michaela. Michaela Hicks, as she was then known, graduated from Olmsted Falls High at the top of her class, our class, class of 97. She attended the United States Military Academy and graduated in the class of 2001. While at West Point, she became the very first female in the history of the Academy to graduate from the SAFRA Leadership Course. Michaela served multiple deployments and bases and places all over the globe, including Korea, Iraq, and Afghanistan. After stepping away from military service, Michaela dedicated her life to a different mission, assisting those children of the world with little access to basic needs that we take for granted here, such as education, healthcare, or a loving family. Michaela became the executive director of A Family for Every Orphan, an international non-governmental organization dedicated to finding loving families for orphans in their home country. Just like Charles Harding, Michaela was blessed by God with so many gifts in her life, but she was not blessed with length of years. Her life was tragically cut short last September 30th, jogging on her lunch break while working at the U.S. Embassy in Kiev, Ukraine. Her mark on those who knew her and loved her will carry on as long as we carry on. We are blessed to have our parents here tonight, Michael and Celeste Hicks. well. Mike Bell loved this community, this school, its administration, her teachers, her coaches, her fellow students. She loved all of it. She was inspired and challenged by this place, and it drove her to attend West Point and pursue the path of leadership, public service, and charitable works. Her family wanted me to convey specifically to so many of you in this room and those who came before you their collective thanks. It was your foundational teaching, your coaching, your encouragement, your demand for excellence that set her on the path to accomplish so much in 41 years. This school district and those leaders set the course that drove Michael and countless others like me to go out into this world and excel. On behalf of so many of us, we thank you. Pivoting to today, the Harding Kickstarter Scholarship will be used to provide assistance to Olmsted Falls seniors who endeavor to enter a life of public service. For those who seek to serve in a charitable or service capacity, whether it be in the military, the Peace Corps, become a teacher, a nurse, a social worker, a Red Cross volunteer, a firefighter, or a police officer, this scholarship was created and designed for you. We hope that the scholarship becomes a sought-after prize that fosters discussion among students, that shines a light on another road less traveled, or perhaps most importantly, that piques the interest of any Olmsted Falls Holden Caulfields out there trying to solve the eternal question at the ripe old age of 16 as to what do I want to do with my life. This scholarship is for you. Our association will be dedicating a plaque at the high school to the memories of Charles Harding and Michael Hicksiler to honor their accomplishments, remember their sacrifices, and to answer the question of any wandering passerby years from now as to who Harding Hicksiler were. I wish everyone in this class of 2021 all the best of luck. You deserve it. You've certainly earned our respect and admiration for overcoming the challenges and adversities normal times would present, but are exponentially compounded in the COVID universe we now live. To the five students who are the inaugural recipients of this award, our hope is that you continue down your desired path of providing service to others. And here's the best part. You don't need to be superhuman or Herculean in your efforts. It's far simpler than that. Keep an eye out for those who may be out of favor. Look for those who may go unnoticed, may be ignored, or may have fallen off their stride, and seek out those who are struggling and may just need a friend. And when you do that, you'll be carrying on the legacy of Charles and my friend, Michael. It is my honor to present the first class of the Harding Hicks Public Service Scholarship to the following five individuals: Noah Barrett, Ryan Feskinich, Brianna Alpine, Andrew Parkowski, and Simon Scudis.
Scholarship, which is awarded to a senior player on the girls' fast pitch team, whose family has also been involved in the OGFBA. I'm relatively new to the world of fast pitch, about a year now, and when I was told that we had to, as an association, we had to choose one winner from this year's senior class, I said, that's not going to be possible. So we ended up doing two scholarships. And those winners are Sarah Zawadzki and Keely Patton.
After Sandy is asking us for the two winners. This year, results ended up being having three people who actually tied. We're giving out five scholarships this year. So the three people in third place are Sarah Langa, Jacob McCabe, Allison Vaverka. Person who received the second most votes was Cassandra Moila. And the person with the most votes this year was Lindsay LaPinta. This is the first year that we're going to be able to display the artwork of the winners. It will be on display out in the lobby as you're exiting, if you'd like to see any of it. And throughout the year, all of the entries are displayed in the showroom lobby if anybody would like to stop by and see them. Next up is Virginia Wendland.
Congratulations, class of 2021. On behalf of Homestead Falls Masters and Forensics patrons, I am pleased to present four scholarships to the following students. Justin Bartholomew. Claire Oliver. Alexis Wendland. Amanda Wu. Next, we have Homestead Falls Music Association.
Hi, everybody. On behalf of the Homestead Falls Music Association, I want to say congratulations, class of 2021. It's going to be a special class to me because I started doing this when you guys were freshmen. And for anybody in the band and choir, I've been to every single event that you guys have done in the last 4 years. I hope that something I did in there benefited you guys and helped out. So we have three scholarships this year. They're $1,000 each. The first one is Alex Thompson. Claire Oliver. And Emma Barnard. Congratulations. Next up is the Homestead Falls PTAs.
Hello again. I am proud to stand up here on behalf of the Homestead Falls PTA units. There are six units who spent the time reading through your applications and making their difficult decisions. Those units are Early Childhood, Falls Lenox, ECC, the intermediate school, middle school, high school, and the PTA council. While PTA membership is always appreciated and strongly encouraged to receive a PTA scholarship, it is not always the deciding factor. PTA scholarships are funded by all the fundraising efforts at each PTA unit, but as we know, many fundraising opportunities never happen this year. While we missed out on the high school talent show, dodgeball, and many breakfast buddies, the PTA still found a way to host dine-outs, 50-50 raffles, popcorn and cookie dough, fundraisers, and pizza nights. So all of those times that you supported a PTA fundraiser, remember, a piece of it goes to scholarships that your child may benefit from. With that being said, we are so proud of all the PTA units who really dug deep this year to be able to award 36 seniors with over $10,000 worth of scholarship money. So on behalf of the PTA, we'd like to congratulate the class of 2021 and present our 36 scholarship recipients. I'll be reading for all of the PTA units, and I have my helpers, Jen Fugar and Kathy Campbell, up here with all the envelopes. I will ask if you hold your applause for each, after I list each unit recipient. So Olmsted Falls Early Childhood PTA, congratulations to the following three recipients: Rachel Korba, Mia Marsico, and Fallon Murray. On behalf of the Falls Lenox ECC PTA, congratulations to the following five recipients: Kevin Allen, Emma Barnard, Shreya Desai, Samantha Liebenauer, and Allison Milligan. On behalf of the Olmsted Falls Intermediate PTA, congratulations to the following five recipients: Alexis Bella, Alex Kandow, Morgan Demoy, Kathy Doherty, and Jimmy Lippis. On behalf of the Olmsted Falls Middle School PTA, congratulations to the following two recipients: Jimmy Cooney and Lainey Waters. Congratulations to the following 14 recipients: Rebecca Abbott, Noah Barrett, Anthony DeMarco, Brian Drobnik, Catherine Grow, Eleanor Getz, Rebecca Johnson, Lindsay LaPinta, Henry Long, Adam Mader, Claire Oliver, Andrew Parkowski, Keely Patton, and Simon Skutak. Lastly, on behalf of the Olmsted Falls PTA Council, congratulations to the following seven recipients: Caroline Gardner, Michaela Kosar, Luke Lavelle, Maggie Lloyd, Tyler Lofton, Jacob McCabe, Haley McCullough.
Hello, everyone. On behalf of the Olmsted Falls High School Math Department, I have the pleasure of presenting the Math Future Educator of the Year Scholarship. The winner of this year's award I have known since her freshman year, and she has always expressed her desire to be a math teacher to me. This is completely evident in the fact that this year she asked to be my student teacher for my first period algebra class when she totally could have just slept in and came in late. But even when we were virtual, woke up and has been helping my students all year round. She has already taught more in front of a live class than I did in my entire first year of college, which speaks volumes to her as a person. She is a natural with my students and has the passion and heart for this career. I cannot wait for the day when I get to call her my colleague.
Congratulations, Rebecca Johnson.
Can everybody hear me? Good evening, class of 2021. My name is Joanna Doherty. This year I get to present for post-prom 2021. We are going to have a fabulous time at prom and after prom, so I hope you guys are excited. I will be presenting 18 scholarships to our well-deserving senior. It is bittersweet this year because I have a senior out there tonight, and I know many of you in the auditorium. I've watched you grow alongside my kiddo, and I'm very excited for the next chapter of your life. I'm happy you're graduating. Happy that your graduation is approaching, but sad that your time at Olmsted Falls is done. So congratulations, and I wish you all the best. And did you read my little blurb in here that I get to pass out the fun and fabulous scholarship? So the first one we're going to do is Brian Berg. Colin Clark. Armand Jessic. Georgia Pelly. Nolan Kozuk. Sophia Conroy. Ryan Kukler. Kyle Necker. Jason Paleo. Jacob Schaefer. John Skinner. Lillian Sovoy. Isaac Spill. Emily Summerauer. Ashley Condon. Olivia Turple. Michael Day. And Daisy Ross.
Is the Ryko Sports Athletic and Academic Scholarship goes to
four people. Anaysa Kummerfer. If you can wait till I'm done with all four, thank you. Michaela Ellis, Andrew Parkowski, and Thomas Bass.
The Joshua Hemrick Memorial Scholarship goes to Grace Simon.
The Ohio Restoration Solutions Scholarship goes to George Kerr.
Association is a professional organization that consists of the faculty and support personnel of Olmsted Falls City School District. Our goal as a community of educators is to inspire, develop, and encourage positive development of the human character through academics and extracurricular activities. As a representative of the association, it's my honor to represent scholarships for two graduating seniors in the amount of $665 each. These students will be entering the field of education during their post-secondary career. They both demonstrated strong character and academic excellence and will pay it forward by inspiring future generations of students. Congratulations to Kirsten Baum and Connor Simon for earning the OFBA scholarship.
The next scholarship is the Olmsted Falls High School Office Aid Scholarship. It goes to Michaela Kozar.
The Olmsted Falls Soccer Association Scholarships go to Kevin Allen and Tate Blaine.
The following three students are being awarded the OFHS Student Council Award: Allison Milligan, Rachel Palmer, and Keely Patton.
The recipient of the Donna Schwaben Joseph Holzer Memorial Scholarship Award goes to Anthony Castrogano.
The recipient of the McKinney Family Endowed Scholarship is Grace Simon.
The Ina L. Schuster Memorial Scholarships go to Shavit Najib and Alexis Wenling.
Irving Award, the Tovar Nevada Trust Music Scholarship, Theo Humphrey, and Amanda Wu. The recipient of the Kovar Memorial Scholarship is Cheyenne Gross. The following two students are being awarded the OFHS International and Multicultural Club Scholarship, Lindsay LaPinta and Katie Patton. The recipient of the National Honor Society Scholarship is Amarjali Diaz. Following student is being awarded the NEPSCO Scholarship, Danielle Andrews. The recipient of the Ernie Sylvester Memorial Scholarship is Grace Simon. Student receiving the Sabrina Pallotta Memorial Scholarship is Nathaniel Wicker. The Mateo's Restaurant Scholarship goes to Carson Balfour. The Chase Scholarship recipient is Ray Simon. We have two students receiving the OPSI Local 361 Scholarship, and they are Rebecca Johnson and Austin Plake. The recipient of the Renaissance Retirement Campus Scholarship is Anaisa Comerford. The
J. Hayes DDS Scholarship goes to Alexis Wendling. The following 10 students will be receiving a scholarship from PEPA: Rebecca Abbott, Heidi Delphel, Sharia Daysuk, Catherine Doherty, Caitlin Papusta, Riley Ives, Sophia Conroy, Henry Long, and Alexis Wendling, and Amanda Wood. Memorial Scholarship for Music and the Performing Arts, and the family has asked me to read a message on their behalf to the class of 2021. Good evening, class of 2021, and congratulations. On May 26, 2000, our beautiful and talented daughter, Dara, collapsed on the Olmsted Falls track after winning the 400-meter race in physical education class. It was on the last day of school of her freshman year. 21 years have passed since that tragic day, and the heartache and sadness does not ease with time. Dara was preparing herself for a future in the performing arts. Her beautiful voice was known throughout the community. She was aspiring to become a professional opera singer and planned to study music and vocal performance after graduating. Today, in Dara's memory, we recognize a senior who also has a passion for the music and performing arts. This year, our recipient of the Dara Hosta Memorial Scholarship for Music and the Performing Arts is Claire Oliver. Mrs. Parkowski and Dr. DeMarco will be awarding the Board of Education Scholarships.
Good evening, class of 2021. On behalf of myself, Dr. DeMarco, Mrs. Tomash, Mrs. Newman, and Mr. Eckenrode, we are thrilled to announce the winners of our Board of Education scholarships. If you can please hold your applause, as there are many scholarships to give out for this. Basil Abu Akaz, Jacob Aldridge, Nicholas Almendinger, Isabel Cameron, Heidi Deufel, Anthony DeMarco, William Diston, Sean Dewar, Max Fontana, Luke Gillette, Nick Hearn, Sophia Kateris,
thank you.
program.
Will everyone please rise?
Kids in my office, for good reasons or bad reasons, I talk a lot about representing the Olmsted Falls entity and representing your family, which I reference Olmsted Falls High School to be one large family. Sandy Smith, you totally served like a champion in this entire process. I want to recognize you one more time. I think you're dignified in that. So let's give Sandy a round of applause. All about the kids, but I do want to pull up one adult onto the stage, and she has no idea I'm doing this, neither do her colleagues. But Lisa Palmerson, can you come on up, please? You know my style, right? Many of you don't know, this will be Lisa's last year here at Olmsted Falls. It's not a retirement, so we will not insult her and wish her well in her retirement. She's well, not close to that age, but Lisa has served Olmsted Falls High School for 14 years. The reason I'm doing this is twofold: to honor Lisa for her time, her diligent servanthood to the students of Olmsted Falls, but also as an example of pursuing her passions. Lisa, in the last few years, completed her private practice license and has been going into the field to serve people in the areas of mental health and support. And I believe this is a great example for all of our students that no matter where you are at in your life, that you should always pursue your passion. Over her 14 years, she's built lasting relationships. She serves, if I did the math right, 5,600 kids or so, if I did about 400 on your caseload. And we're proud to say that you've done your job well. The conclusion of any of our careers, we want to hear your job. And so, job well done, faithful servant. Give her a round of applause. Thanks for being an example, not only in the job, but also to pursue your passions. Ms. Calderon, I'm going to be back to Mike, and I'm going to go back into my seat, so thank you.
Thank you. That was beautiful. Okay, thank you everyone for coming tonight. Just a reminder, if you received a scholarship in a blue envelope, please make your way as you're exiting to the atrium. There's a Bulldogs backdrop. They want to take a picture of all of the students that won an alumni scholarship. That's what that blue envelope means. Well, tonight, that concludes our Honor Night program. So on behalf of the faculty and administration of Olmsted Falls City School District, I'd like to congratulate the class of 2021. The future is yours for the taking. We believe in you, we love you, and we know you'll make a positive impact in this world. Congratulations.